हाँ जी
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द चैप्टर ऑफ एंटीडॉट्स। सो बिफोर टेलिंग यू समथिंग अबाउट एंटीडॉट्स, यू शुड नो व्हाट इज ए पॉइजन। पॉइजन इज एनीथिंग, एनी सब्सटेंस इंजेस्टेड इन योर बॉडी बाय एनी रूट, बी इट माउथ, इनहेलेशन, इंजेक्शन, बाय वॉट एवर रूट, इट विल डेफिनेटली प्रोड्यूस इनिशियली अ डिजीज एंड देन फाइनली द डेथ। इट डिपेंड्स इन हाउ मच अमाउंट यू हैव कंज्यूम्ड दैट पॉइजन। सो पॉइजन विल फाइनली प्रोड्यूस अ डिजीज एंड ए डेथ एडमिनिस्टर्ड बाय एनी रूट। सो पॉइजनिंग इज मेनली एक्यूट पॉइजनिंग। वेन इट इज एक्यूट पॉइजनिंग इज ऑफ फोर टाइप्स: एक्सीडेंटल, ऑक्यूपेशनल, सुसाइडल एंड क्रिमिनल। एक्सीडेंटल पॉइजनिंग, द मेन रीजन ऑफ एक्सीडेंटल पॉइजनिंग इज सेल्फ मेडिकेशन। सेल्फ मेडिकेशन मीन्स व्हेन यू टेंड टू टेक योर मेडिसिन बाय योरसेल्फ विदाउट कंसल्टिंग एनी डॉक्टर, एनी फार्मासिस्ट और एनी रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन, रजिस्टर्ड फार्मासिस्ट। So you should properly consult a physician, a doctor, a pharmacist before taking any medicine. So that is the accidental poisoning. Second is occupational poisoning. Sometimes you are working with chemicals, but due to ignorance, you don't know that this chemical contains potassium cyanide or hydrogen cyanide. So you inhale those vapors or you ingest potassium cyanide by mistake and then it leads to poisoning. Third is suicidal. When you have negative thoughts on your mind and you feel that suicide is the only way for all your problems, only solution for all problems, but this is not true. So you should always have positive thinking so that there are no suicidal tendencies. And fourth is criminal. When a person who is a criminal is caught with police and he knows that he will have to face so many tortures from the police, he immediately inhales or ingests the cyanide and he dies immediately. Because from inhalation, the death occurs within seconds, within minutes. But from oral ingestion, death may take some minutes or even some hours. So inhalation is the fastest route through which you consume poison and you die immediately. So criminals use this method of inhalation and they smell the poison, they inhale the poison and they immediately die so that they are not caught by the police. So that were the four types of acute poisoning. Now, how do we counteract the effect of poison? By taking a suitable antidote. So what is an antidote? Anti means against, which will act against the poison. So antidote, it is an agent which counteracts a poison. Counteract means you have to produce an effect which is opposite to that effect. Suppose this A is producing some effect, but when you want to counteract this effect, you will produce the opposite effect. B will produce the opposite effect of A. That is counteracting them. That means you have to nullify the poison, you have to counteract it, you have to dismantle it, you have to inactivate it. You can use any words. That is the main purpose of antidote. That whatever poison you have inhaled by any of these routes, by any of these methods, it will be, it has to be excreted out from your body. So first of all, you should know that how many types of antidotes are available. So this is based on the mechanism of action. We have three types of antidotes. First is physiological. certain effects which are opposite to the desired one. Suppose poison is causing you death, but you have to produce some effects which will counteract that effect, which will produce the opposite effect. So that is the physiological poison antidote. The example is, suppose in hemoglobin we are taking sodium nitrite as an antidote, then what it will do? It will convert hemoglobin into methemoglobin. This is the opposite effect, some other effect, right? Producing some other effects. Second type of antidote is chemical antidote. Chemical, the name indicates, that means it will change the chemical nature of poison. Like there are cyanide ions which are toxic in nature. So what sodium thiosulfate will do? It will convert these toxic cyanide ions into non-toxic thiocyanate ions. This we will study in detail when we will study the treatment of cyanide poisoning. And second is your EDTA. EDTA is also an example of chemical poisoning because it changes the chemical nature. It is used in the heavy metals poisoning. When by chance you have ingested any heavy metals in very large amounts, so EDTA will chelate that metals and that poison will be nullified. So it mainly EDTA acts as a chelating agent over there. Third type of antidote is mechanical antidote. That means it will prevent the absorption of poison into your body. First is activated charcoal. Second is copper sulfate. Third is magnesium sulfate. And fourth example is disodium hydrogen phosphate. So they will prevent the absorption of poison in our body. That is mechanical antidotes. So these were the three types of antidotes based on the mechanism of action. Now coming to the causes. What you have ingested or what you have inhaled that will cause the death or any serious signs and symptoms. So example is you have either inhaled hydrogen cyanide, cyanogen chloride, cyanamide, any silver polish, or finally the potassium cyanide, which causes death in seconds. So these are the chemicals which when consumed will cause the death. And what are the signs and symptoms? How will you identify that it is a case of cyanide poisoning? Initially, the patient will suffer nausea, a feeling of dizziness, chakkar aayenge usko, chakkar aake girne lagega, fir dyspnea, dyspnea means shortness of breath, usko ekdam saans aana, saans lene mein problem aayegi, saans aana kam ho jayega usko. Dizziness, chakkar aana, convulsions, daure padna, daure ki tarah padne shuru ho jayenge usko, jaise chakkar aane shuru ho jayenge. And finally coma mein chala jayega wo, and finally the death. So these are the signs and symptoms of cyanide poisoning. Now let us see the mechanism, how the cyanide poisoning happens, how it stops your all the processes of the body. Now what happens is, we have a blood in our body which contains ferricals, right? So by chance if you have ingested cyanide, so cyanide will combine with ferric ions of the hemoglobin in the presence of an enzyme cytochrome oxidase. So these cyanide ions, once they will enter your blood circulation, they will immediately stop your electron transfer reactions, which will finally stop your cellular respiration. So once the cellular respiration stops, then everything stops. This is the mechanism through which
cyanide causes the death. Initially, it will stop the transfer of all the electrons in your body, all reactions, all chemical reactions, and finally, it will affect your respiration. It will stop your cellular respiration. So, how to treat the cyanide poisoning? If you have ingested it by mistake, how will you get the treatment? So, if you will take the patient to the hospital, what the doctor will do? He will give you an injection of sodium nitrite initially. What sodium nitrite will do? It will convert ferrous ions of hemoglobin into ferric ions of hemoglobin, which will finally be converted to in the hemoglobin to form methemoglobin. So this is the first step of sodium nitrite. So once the methemoglobin is formed, it will react with the toxic cyanide ions in our body to form cyan methemoglobin. This is cyan methemoglobin. This protects our enzymes from cyanide ions. Right? So these two steps are initially treated with sodium nitrite. So in these two steps there is the action of sodium nitrite. Conversion of ferrous ion to ferric ions forming methemoglobin, and this methemoglobin will react with cyanide ions to give you cyan methemoglobin, which will protect our enzymes of the body from the cyanide ions. This was the role of sodium nitrite initially. So after 5 minutes, the doctor will give you intravenous infusion of sodium thiosulfate. Intravenous means it will go into the veins. And what is infusion? When a medicine is given drop by drop in your blood circulation. So, what sodium thiosulfate will do? It will react with the cyanide ions in your body, which are toxic. It will convert these toxic cyanide ions into non-toxic thiocyanate ions. In the presence of an enzyme, rhodanase, and the second enzyme is thiocyanate oxidase. So mainly the oxidation is going on. And this non-toxic thiocyanate gets excreted from the body in the form of urine. So in the urine, all non-toxic thiocyanate is excreted out. So these two, sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate, they are given together. Right? Initially we will give sodium nitrite. Then after these reactions, after 5 minutes, we'll give the intravenous sodium thiosulfate. The second treatment which we can give is, we can give hyperbaric oxygen. Hyper means in excess amount. Baric means these are the units of pressure. So we have to give oxygen at a high pressure in our body, so that this high pressure oxygen will displace all the cyanide ions from our body with oxygen. It will replace all the cyanide ions with oxygen, and all cyanide ions will be eliminated from our body. So this is the main treatment pattern of any cyanide poisoning. Thank you so much for listening.